Good evening, dear students. So we have this questions of this grand test where the first year portions have been covered, isn't it? So we'll be having this discussion of this. This session is under record. So the botanical gardens. So the botanical gardens, what are they having? Have collections of living plants for reference. Is an exit to conservation strategy. Contains labeled plants indicating its botanical scientific name and family, or all of the above. So what is the answer for this? See, botanical gardens, the have all this property. They are not only collection of living plants for reference, it is also an exit to conservation strategy. It contains labeled plants which indicates botanical or scientific name and family. So all of the above are correct options for botanical garden. Okay. So that is the option for the botanical garden. So the next question, alveoli of the lungs are lined by which epithelium? So it is alveoli of the lungs, they are lined by simple squamous epithelium. So it's a very simple answer. Simple squamous epithelium, not stratified or simple cuboidal or stratified. It is simple squamous epithelium is the lining of epithelium which lines the alveoli of the lungs. So read the following table carefully and select the correct option for W, X, Y, and Z. So biological name, wheat, they have given Triticum aestivation. Mango is Mangifera indica. So W should be Mangifera indica. So there are two options, second and fourth. So wheat belongs to Poaceae family. X should be Poaceae. So the fourth answer, W is Mangifera indica, X is Poaceae, Y is Poales, Z is Anacardiaceae and Sapindales. So that is the correct option. So fourth option is correct. So scientific name is Mangifera indica. The wheat belongs to grass family, so it is Poaceae. Order is Poales and Z. So the mango belongs to Anacardiaceae family. Order is Sapindales. So fourth one is the correct option. Okay. In the given list, how many animals have complete double circulation? So complete double circulation. See, crocodiles have complete double circulation. Birds have complete double circulation. Mammals have it. Okay. Alligator might also have this complete circulation because they are a variety of crocodiles, isn't it? So as per this, crocodile, birds, mammals, three. Then there is alligator. So the answer is four is correct. See, since alligator is also closely related with crocodiles, see, three varieties are there: crocodile, alligator, gharial. So they all are under the same group. Okay. So only in their snout, they have different shapes. So alligator, crocodile, birds, mammals, they have this complete double circulation. So answer is four in the list have double circulation. See, you should be prepared for this sort of question also. Many times they have asked it in NEET. Okay, so based on examples. So example-oriented questions they are. So dinoflagellates have two flagella. So dinoflagellates have two flagella. So goniolex, you can remember about. So one is transverse, another is so longitudinal and transverse, you'll be having it. So both lying longitudinally between the wall plates, this is wrong. One lying longitudinally and the other transversely in a furrow between the wall plates. Second one is the correct option for 95th. So 95th, second option is the correct option. Okay. So third one, so 96th question. So read the statements with regard to frog. Which of the statement is or are correct and incorrect? Okay. So the medulla oblongata, passes out through foramen of Monroe and continues into spinal cord. So vasa efferentia 10 to 12 in number that arise from testis. Okay, ovaries have no functional connection with kidneys. Okay, frogs are uricotelic. Okay, so of this, second and third statements are correct, while first and fourth statement are incorrect. So second and third statement are correct, and the first and fourth statement are incorrect. So 97th question, identify the virus. So it's a bacteriophage, T4 bacteriophage, and name the structure marked A, B, C, D, and E. So it's a bacteriophage. First of all, identify the virus and name the structure. So it's a bacteriophage. All the options are correct. A is head part of it. In all the options, they are correct. B is sheath or collar. So collar is correct part of it. C, bacteriophage, A is head, B is collar, C is sheath, so tail part of it, it is sheath, D is tail fibers, and E is basal plate, so the hexagonal basal plate with pecs. So I was just searching for the answer for pecs. So they have labeled it at that, but they have not given it as pecs. Instead, the entire thing, they have labeled it as basal plate. Hexagonal basal plate. So D option is correct for 97. So it's a bacteriophage. A is head, collar, sheath, tail sheath, it is tail fibers, and base plate. So contribution of India in global species diversity is, is it 1.8% or is it 2.4%? Or is it 8.1% or 4.2%? So the answer, as per your NCERT book, it is 8.1%. So 98% is the correct option. So in gymnosperms, ovules are not enclosed by ovary. Very true. Ovules remain exposed both before and after fertilization. Very true. Seeds are naked and not covered by fruit. Third option is also correct. All are correct. So all the four options are correct. For 99th question, gymnosperms, all the three options are correct. D is the answer for 99th. In man, tinea coli are external bulged out pouches of colon, longitudinal muscular folds of rectum, external bulged out pouches of rectum, longitudinal muscular folds of colon. So what is tinea coli? So this is out of syllabus. You might not have come across this option. So it is nothing but longitudinal muscular folds of colon. So tinea, so we have that, isn't it? So for the tapeworm, so tinea coli, you can remember. So coli itself indicates colon part of it. So longitudinal muscular folds of colon, we call it as tinea coli. So remember it that way, colon, coli. So longitudinal, it is muscular folds. So next one is, they have given the classes of the pteridophytes and you have to identify the correct examples. Xylopsida, very easy, xyloterm. A is 4, only one option is there. So by identifying first answer itself, you'll be able to unlock the others. Lycopsida, B3, selaginella and lycopodium. Spinopsida, so you have the equisetum, second one. Teropsida, dryopteris, teres, and adiantum, the maiden hair fern. So we call it as adiantum. So fourth option is correct for 101. So triglycerides in the chylomicrons are digested by. So triglycerides in the chylomicrons are digested by gastric lipase, lingual lipase, intestinal lipase, or is it lipoprotein lipase? So triglycerides in the chylomicrons are digested by which of them? So it is lipoprotein lipase. Lipase is going to digest triglycerides in the chylomicrons. So it is going to be lipoprotein lipase. Okay. So the answer is 102. Fourth one is the answer. 103. Select the correct statements. Okay. From the region of elongation, some epidermal cells form root hairs. Okay. So it is at the region of maturation, you find the root hairs, not elongation. So that statement is wrong. Pneumatophores are seen in rhizophora. This is correct. Breathing roots are seen in rhizophora. Adventitious roots are seen in the banyan trees, which we call it as prop roots. Okay. Maize and sugarcane have stilt roots, not prop roots. So B and C are correct. D is wrong. So the fourth option, B and C, are correct here. A and C are incorrect statements. Okay. So the next question, that is the 104th question. Note the following: active process, B, passive process, decrease in pulmonary volume, increase in pulmonary volume, relaxation of diaphragm, contraction of diaphragm. From the above aspects, which are suitable to normal expiration in human beings? So which of these are suitable to normal expiration in human beings? So the options are B, C, and E. It's a passive process, normal expiration. C, there is a decrease in pulmonary volume, so there is expiration. So decrease in pulmonary volume. E, so there is a relaxation of diaphragm. So as a result of it, the decrease in pulmonary volume happens. So 104, third option is correct. Any doubts regarding this? I'll clarify it at the end of the session. Okay. Next one, 105 question. So match the column with respect to placentation. Okay. Axial placentation. So examples they have given. So axial placentations, in which of them do you notice? In tomato, lemon, China rose, that is hibiscus, you notice that. So A is 3. So third option. So first and third option has this A is 3. Okay, parietal placentation. So it is at the margins. So parietal, you can notice that in mustard and argimone. So B is 4. A is 3, B is 4. Free central, so you have that in dianthus and primrose, passion fruit. So free central placentation. Basal placentation is in sunflower and marigold. So they have this basal placentation. So third one is the correct option for 105. 106. Which of the following would have the same oxygen content? So the 106 question, which of the following would have the same oxygen content? So blood entering the lungs or blood leaving the lungs? So do they have the same oxygen content? No. Okay. So blood entering the right side of the heart, blood leaving the right side of the heart. So here they have the same oxygen content. So right side of the heart, it would be receiving the pure blood, and the from the right ventricle, the impure blood. So it would be receiving the impure blood. So blood entering the right side of the heart and blood leaving the right side of the heart. So is going to be the same oxygen content will be there. Because from the right atrium, they enter into the right ventricle. Okay. So from the right ventricle, they are pumped through the pulmonary artery. So they'll be having the same amount of oxygen. So blood entering the right side of the heart, blood leaving the right side of the heart is the correct option. Parkinsonia and Australian acacia are popular examples of fill load. So Parkinsonia is a plant. So fill load, leaf modification it is. So any part of the leaf which takes up the which looks like a leaf and takes up the function of leaf. We call it as fill load. It can be the petiole modification. So those things you can notice in Parkinsonia and Australian acacia. So 107, second one is the correct answer. So it is fill load. So 107 is B, second option is the right. So 108, read the following about blood clotting. So prothrombin, prothrombin activator, C, it is going to become A. So what is the A? So thrombin it would be, okay. Then, so they are going to form E. So from thrombin, E, B, and D. So we have to find out this correct sequence for, so 108. So thrombin is very easy. So they have given it in all of them. So soluble fibrin is E. So the B part of it is soluble fibrin. That also they have given. Okay. So the C part of it, so soluble fibrin, they have given. So the C part, so from prothrombin to A, they have to form, that is thrombin. So you have to identify E is going to be insoluble fibrinogen. Okay. So 108. So thrombin, soluble fibrin. So thrombin, soluble fibrin, B. C is factor 4. D is factor 13. Okay. And E is soluble fibrinogen. So from soluble fibrinogen, they are going to become soluble fibrin. And soluble fibrin in presence of factor 13, they are going to form insoluble fibrin. So first one is a correct option for 108. Okay. So 109, the next question. If recombinant DNA is inserted within the coding sequence of enzyme, galactosidase. So coding sequence of enzyme galactosidase DNA is inserted. So this coding sequence of this enzyme will be inactivated. Okay. Insertional inactivation, you know of that. So which of the following will occur in case of non-recombinants? Okay. So insertional inactivation, colonies do not produce any color. So chromogenic substrate gives blue color. Yes, so there is chromogenic substrate gives blue color. So this would be happening in case of non-recombinant. So chromogenic substrate gives blue color. So this is what you have to remember regarding this particular case. So this is there in the NCERT book. You please go through this aspect of it. So the chromogenic substrate gives blue color in case of non-recombinants. Consider the following four statements and select the correct option. Fish heart contains only oxygenated blood. Closure of atria ventricular valves produce the sound heart, second heart sound, that is dub. So they have given here. Columnae cerce occur in the atria. Purkinje fibers are nerve fibers present in the heart wall. So select the correct options that are there. Okay. So we have to proceed with this false and true statements we have to find. So this is also a new variety of questions that they are asking in NEET. So it would be very helpful for you to identify the correct and false statements here. So the first statement, heart contains only oxygenated blood, it is false. Okay. Second one, so closure of auriculoventricular valves produces the second heart sound, that is also false. So semilunar valves closing, it produces the dub sound. Okay. Atrioventricular valves closing, it produces lub. So that is also false. Columnae cerne occur in the atria. That is also false. So Purkinje fibers are nerve fibers present in the heart wall. So that fourth one is true. So false, 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 and true. So 110, the answer is false, 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 true. In QB, bacteriophage genetic material is? In QB, bacteriophage genetic material is it DNA or RNA or protein? Bacteriophage genetic material or none of them? So the 111, the correct answer is B, that is RNA. In QB, bacteriophage genetic material is RNA. Angiotensinogenase is secreted by juxtaglomerular cells, juxtamedullary cells, or is it liver or lungs? So which of them secrete this angiotensinogenase? So it is juxtaglomerular cells. Juxtaglomerular cells secretes this angiotensinogenase. So that is the enzyme it secretes, juxtaglomerular cells. So which of the following statements are correct for sapwood? You know, sapwood is also called as the softwood, isn't it? It does not help in water conduction. It is light colored, that is correct. It is also called alburnum. Sapwood is also called as alburnum, correct. Its tracheary elements are filled with tannins, resins, oil. So the first fourth statements are wrong. It is hard and durable. First, fourth, and fifth are wrong. So second and third are correct statements. So for sapwood, second and third are correct statements. Remaining are all incorrect statements. Under 114, choose the correct one regarding urinary excretion. So urinary excretion equals glomerular filtration, tubular reabsorption, and tubular secretion. This is the correct sequence. So glomerular filtration minus tubular secretion plus tubular secretion. So that is the correct aspect of urinary excretion. Okay. So 114th is D. 115th. Bean-shaped guard cell, dicot leaf. Three it is. Dumbbell-shaped guard cell, monocot leaf, two. So 3, 2, where do you find that? So dumbbell-shaped guard cell, monocot leaf. Okay. 3 and 2. So there is only one option of 3 and 2. Second one is right. Trichome is present in dicot stem, exarch, xylemen, dicot, and monocot root. So D4, correct it is. So second option in 115, second option is correct. Okay. 116, the change that takes place in Cori-Cori cycle is, so this is again outside the syllabus part of it, the change that takes place in Cori-Cori cycle is, so glycogen is formed from lactic acid in liver. The change that takes place in Cori-Cori cycle is glycogen is formed from lactic acid in liver. So that is the third option is correct. So when you are talking about Cori-Cori cycle, it is glycogen is formed from lactic acid in liver. So 116, third one is the correct one. Steel excludes. So what does the steel excludes? Pericycle, vascular bundles, pith, or endodermis. So steel excludes endodermis. 117th, D is the answer, or fourth one is the answer. So it excludes endodermis. The shoulder blade is made of, so what is the shoulder blade made of? Clavicle, humerus, ilium, scapula. So what is the shoulder blade made of? So the 118th, the answer is clavicle, collarbone. So it is clavicle or the collarbone. Select the wrong match. Alleroplast, protein storage, correct. Elaioplast, fat or oil storage. Amyloplast, starch storage. Etioplast, chlorophyll storage. This is wrong. Fourth one is wrong. Study following statements. Okay. So which of the above are correct? We should find out. Summation of postsynaptic potential occurs at axon hillock. That is correct statement. Action potentials are developed when the EPSPs are greater than the IPSPs. So efflux of potassium ion causes repolarization. So here all the three statements are correct. 1, 2, and 3, all the three statements are correct. So 1/20th, fourth is the correct answer. So study the name of different cell organelles or structures given below. How many of them above are bound by single membrane? Okay. So you have to identify how many of them are bound by single membrane. So peroxisome, lysosome, mitochondria, Golgi complex, endoplasmic reticulum, ribosome, lysosome, ribosome, chromosome, thylakoid, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six of them are bound by single membrane. You just have to remove the double membrane, mitochondria, Golgi complex, endoplasmic reticulum. They are double membranes. Remaining are all single membranes. So six of them are there. Okay. So 122nd, visual impulses. Of the retina of eye reach this part of human brain, superior colliculi, occipital lobe of cerebrum, parietal lobe of cerebrum, pons veroli. So visual impulse from the retina of eye reach the occipital lobe of cerebrum. So 122nd, second one is the correct answer. 123rd, dash is the most abundant protein in animal world, and dash is the most abundant protein in the whole biosphere. So collagen is the most abundant protein in animal world, and Rubisco is the most abundant protein in the whole biosphere. So collagen and Rubisco, fourth is the correct answer. Set of hormones related with maintenance of body temperature is melatonin and thyroxin help in maintenance of body temperature. Osmoregulation, especially of body temperature, melatonin and thyroxin help in the maintenance of body temperature. So 124th, A is the correct answer. So 125th, chitin is present in the cell wall of fungi. Very easy one. So 125th is third one. Now observe the following about hormonal disorders and note the correctly given all the three disorder cause and main symptoms. All of them should be correct. So we should select that correct option for this 126th. See, Addison's disease, hypersecretion of glucocorticoids, loss of weight and muscle weakness. So Addison's disease is wrong part of it. Okay, myxedema, hyposecretion of thyroxine, lethargy, mental impairment. Okay, simple goiter, hypothyroidism, so enlargement of thyroid gland. Tetany, hypoparathyroidism, prolonged contraction of muscles. See, second, third, fourth are correct. All of them are correct except the first one. So second option is the correct one for 126th. So 126th, second option is correct. 127th, arrange the following events of meiosis in the correct sequence. So there is first synapses. Okay. Then, so first is synapses. Second one is crossing over. Third one is terminalization. Fourth one is disjunction of genomes. That is, there is going to be separation of the homologous chromosomes. So disjunction of genomes takes place as the fourth process. So second one is the correct option. So first process is the homologous chromosomes pairs up. There is a crossing over of non-sister chromatids. Then there is terminalization of this crossing, terminalization of this crossing over and disjunction of genomes. That is the homosomal chromosomes get separated. So this is the correct option. So 127, second, third, 3, 2, 1, 4 is the correct option. So match the following and choose the correct combination. So there is Leydig cells, Sertoli cells, prostate cells, Cowper's gland. So these are the combinations that they have. So find out their correct combinations we have to choose in this column one and column two. So 128, so you have this from so what is the correct option for A, Leydig cells? Secretion of testosterone. So Leydig cells is secretion of testosterones. Sertoli cells, nourishing the sperms. Prostate glands, activates the sperms. Cowper's gland, lubricates the urethra. So this A3, B1, C5, D2. So third option is correct for 128. Third option is correct. So Leydig cell, so secretion of testosterone, Leydig and testosterone, you remember it as. Sertoli cells, nourishing the sperms. Prostate glands, activates the sperms. Cowper's glands, lubricates the urethra. Okay, so this third option is correct. How many meiotic divisions are required to produce 1,000 male gametes in a flowering plant? How many meiotic divisions are required to produce 1,000 male gametes in a flowering plant? So it has to be multiplied by 4, isn't it? 250, how many meiotic divisions in the sense? So the 250 meiotic divisions are required for 1,000 male gametes, because all the male gametes are functional, isn't it? So the answer is 129. The answer is D, that is correct answer is. Okay. So 250 cells they have given it as. So 129th, anyone has an issue with this? Let me just read your messages. See, the answer key, they have given 125, which is wrong. So 250 it is, isn't it? So 250 into 4, they are going to lead to the formation of 1,000 male gametes. Okay. Answer key, they have given wrong as 125. So by the end of second trimester in fetus, the body is covered with fine hair, eyelids separate, eyelashes are formed. All these are seen, which is the correct answer. Many times they have asked this part of the question, so you should be careful about this 130th question. So the answer is going to be the all these are seen. The body is covered with fine hairs, eyelids separate, eyelashes are formed. All these are seen in the second trimester. Column one with column two, we have to match them. So lac operon concept it is concerned with. So the 131st, the column one with column two, operator gene. So it is the binding site for repressor molecules. Okay, then promoter site. Binding site for RNA polymerase, structural gene, codes for enzyme protein. Okay, so BAC, regulator gene, codes for repressor molecule. So this is the BACD is the correct option. Second one is the correct option. So you should always remember it in the same sequence, RPOR. So regulator gene, so it is going to code for repressor molecule, okay, promoter site. It is binding site for RNA polymerase, structural genes codes for enzyme protein, and regulator gene codes for repressor molecule. So BACD, second one is the correct option for 131st. So study the following statements and choose the correct option. In periodic abstinence, couples avoid coitus from 17 to 27 day of the menstrual cycle. Okay, you have to choose the correct option. First one itself is wrong. Okay, so the rhythmic method is wrong there. Then Saheli, once a week pill developed by CDRI, Central Drug Research Institute, Lucknow, is a steroidal oral contraceptive. Okay. So diaphragms are the reusable female contraceptive barriers. Okay. LNG 20 is a hormone releasing IUD, intrauterine device. So LNG 20 is a hormone releasing intrauterine device. So the correct options are third and fourth are correct. First and second is wrong. So Saheli, once a week pill developed by CDRI, Lucknow, is a steroidal oral contraceptive. That concept itself is wrong. So the first and second one is wrong. Third and fourth are correct. So now they have given from water potential. Solution A has psi S equals minus 30 bars and psi P equals 5 bars. Solution B have psi S. See, using this, you can form this water potential of A. What is water potential of A? Sum of solute and pressure potential. So it comes to minus 25 bars, solution A. And here it would be minus 10 bars, minus 25 and minus 10 bars. So the two are separated by a semi-permeable membrane. Flow of water will be from higher water potential to lower water potential. So the answer here, what is it going to be? Is it A to B or B to A? So one place it is minus 25, another place it is minus 10. Okay, so the water will be moving from B to A, isn't it? So in 133rd, the answer is B, B to A. Second one is the correct answer. So the following graph shows the level of ovarian hormones during a menstrual cycle. What do 192 represent in this menstrual cycle? In the graph, what does it represent? 192. So is it progesterone, estrogen, or is it FSH, LH, or LH, FSH, or estrogen, progesterone? See the ovarian hormone levels. So it is estrogen, the 14-day maximum will be there, ovulation takes place, isn't it? And progesterone, after this ovulation, the progesterone. So that is, so 192 are nothing but estrogen and progesterone. Fourth one is the correct option. AUG initiation codon occurs over 3' end of mRNA, 5' end of mRNA, short arm of tRNA, long arm of tRNA. It is 5' end of mRNA, 135. Second one is the correct answer. 136, read the statement. So MTP, that is medical termination of pregnancy, is considered relatively safe during the first trimester of pregnancy. Fetus becomes intimately associated with the maternal tissues after the first trimester. So both statement 1 and 2 are correct. So both of these statements are correct. So 135th, 5' end of mRNA, 136th A is the correct answer. So 137th, leg hemoglobin function has oxygen scavenger. So that is also correct. So 137, first one. So if the blood group of man is O and that of his wife is AB plus, so how many of their children have the phenotype for the blood group of father and mother respectively? So blood group of father and mother, it's not at all possible here. A A blood group or B blood group, it would be 0 and 0%. So 138D is the answer. Okay. 139, to remove one molecule of glucose from Kelvin cycle, dash turns of the cycle are required. 6 turns of the Kelvin cycle are required. Okay, so 139th, first one is a correct answer. Find out the mismatch from the following related to skin color of man. Okay, skin color of man. So if it is, all of them are recessive, very fair. So all of them are dominant, very dark, they have given. Then it is intermediate shade, very light. AA, BB, CC. So here you have to find the mismatch from the following related to skin color of man. So 140th question, the answer is D. So AA, BB, CC, very light is a wrong option. Okay, so this is the mismatch, whereas the others are all correct match. So skin color. So here you should also notice more than one gene is involved in the color of skin. So polygenic inheritance, we call it as. Generally, Mendelian principle speaks about one gene, one character. But the skin color of man, so it is polygenic inheritance. That is why there is no dark and light colored. So in between you have many shades, godi banna, ragi banna, all those shades are there because of these genes. So they are polygenic inheritance. So you should remember about that. Observe the diagram given below and identify A, B, and C. So you have this A, B, and C. They have asked you to identify in this. What is this A? So they have given various options. So chlorophyll P700. So it is photosystem 1, isn't it? So B is electron acceptor. C, it is ADP. So fourth option is right for 141st. Fourth option is right. So 142nd, so this is a very interesting thing. You are familiar with Down syndrome, but these are all new things to you. So Down syndrome is trisomy of 21st chromosome. So totally 47 chromosomes will be there. So which of them will be having that, that you have to identify, okay? So match this following features of this abnormalities with the list. So 142nd. So Down syndrome. So Down syndrome, it is 47 and one additional chromosome of 21st chromosome. See, plus 21 means 21st chromosome is additional. So Down syndrome, so the third one, second is the correct option. So Down syndrome, third one is the correct option. So that is the only option here. So you very easily, with first answer itself, you can get the other answers. B, Petau syndrome is 5, 47 chromosomes are there. So there is trisomy of 13. So minus means monosomy, okay? C, so Petau syndrome is also 47. It's a trisomy of 13. Chronic myelogenous leukemia. So the C part of it is first one, 46, T9 is to 22, okay? So 9 and 22, they have this probably trisomy. So there might be some transfer of, might be deletion or other things might be there. So that 46 is the chronic myelogenous leukemia. Cryo-CAT syndrome. So it is, the fragment is lost. So that is fourth one, 46, fifth chromosome. Fragment is lost. So fifth chromosome P minus, they have given it as it's lost. Fragment is lost. So Cryo-CAT syndrome, D is 4. E, Edwards syndrome, 46 chromosome, 18th chromosome trisomy is there. So remember about this trisomy of 18th chromosome. So this T and other things, they represent this, what you call it as the deletion, transfer, and all those are there. Okay. So it is nothing but chromosomal aberration. So because of the loss or gain of fragment of chromosome. Okay. So I hope you have understood this. 142nd, second one is the correct answer. 143rd, the total number of substrate level phosphorylation in cellular respiration as a result of complete oxidation of one glucose molecule is substrate level phosphorylation in cellular respiration because of complete oxidation of one glucose molecule is. So how much of substrate level phosphorylation is going to take place? So the 143rd, the answer is A. So the total number of substrate level phosphorylation in cellular respiration as a result of complete oxidation of one glucose molecule is 6. Okay. So if you remember about that 6, carbons are involved here. So the total number of substrate level phosphorylation, if you calculate that, so it comes to 6. In which of the following organisms, sex of the offspring depends on the type of ovum that is fertilized? Okay, in which of the following organisms, sex of the offspring depends on the type of ovum that is fertilized? Birds and Drosophila, reptiles. See, birds have this, eggs will be heterogametic. They produce two types of gametes. So birds should be there. So reptiles and moths, grasshoppers and moths, it is ruled out. Okay. So birds and Drosophila, cockroaches and birds. So the option is 144th. So it is cockroaches and birds, they have heterogametic. That is, females are going to produce two types of XL. Okay. The ZZZW type of sex inheritance. Okay. So XXXY inheritance is also there. So ZZZW sex inheritance is also there in cockroaches and birds. So 144th. The experimental proof for DNA as genetic material comes from transformation, transduction, conjugation, mutation. So experimental proof for this, it comes from which of them? All the four or any two? So you have to identify that. So in your class, you might have studied the transformation example for this DNA as genetic material. You have that Salmonella typhimurium, isn't it? So the virulent and avirulent variety. So 145th, the answer is A and B. So transformation and transduction are a very good examples for DNA as genetic material. So that experimental proof you can obtain by transformation and transduction. Transduction is a bacteriophage which is going to transfer gene from one bacteria to another bacteria. So there is genetic recombination happening due to bacteriophage. So we call that as transduction. So fourth one, A and B, is the correct answer for the 145th question. See, here you have the pedigree chart you should study. Okay. So there is female and male. So male is affected, female is affected. And in the next generation, between normal, that is, there is a carrier. Here the female might be carrier. Okay. So you have to study the pedigree chart given below and identify what type of gene it might be. Is it recessive or dominant, X-linked, recessive or X-linked, dominant, or is it? So that we have to identify just by the pedigree cross. See, it is not X-linked or anything. It is autosomal recessive. So severe combined immunodeficiency disorder, this example is one. Autosomal recessive condition. So here you need not have to worry about the gender part of it. So autosomal recessive condition is there. So that gets inherited in one of the child and it further proceeds. So it is autosomal. It is not concerned with the sex-linked chromosomes. It is not concerned with that. It shows autosomal recessive, that is severe combined immunodeficiency orders, because within the first generation itself, you can see that both male and female are affected. So it implies that it is an autosomal disorder. Okay, recessive condition it is exhibiting. So you have nearly three, four, five, six. Six of them are there, of which two of them are affected. Four of them are not affected. If it was a dominant gene, so all of them would have been affected. And even in the parent, one of the parent would be affected. So if it was autosomal part of it. But here you find, so recessive nature is getting exhibited. So even in the next couple, so it is, since it is in recessive nature, it is not exhibited there. But in next generation, see, recessive will be exhibited only when it is double recessive. So it is exhibited in the next generation also. It is an autosomal recessive disorder, SCID. So third one is it correct by analyzing the pedigree chart. So which of the following is used for fruit ripening on commercial scale? Ethylene is utilized for ripening of fruits on commercial scale. So 148 question, caterpillar larva of butterfly is similar in body form with its ancestor, the annelid. Statement two, ontogeny repeats phylogeny. So what does it indicate? So both statement one and two are correct, or what are the options for the 148th? So both statements are correct. There is ontogeny recapitulation theory. On that basis, they have given this. Ontogeny, that is development of organs, repeats in phylogeny, evolution. So caterpillar larva of butterfly is similar in body form with its ancestor, the annelids. So from annelids, they might have evolved. So ontogeny repeats phylogeny. So both statement one and two are correct. Okay. Match the following. So this is indole acetic acid, abscisic acid, ethylene, gibberellic acid, cytokinins. So indole acetic acid, so cytokinins, the abscisic acid brings about stomatal closure. So B is 3. So cytokinins brings about bolting. So E is 2. So B is 3, E is 2. It's not 2. E is, D is, B is 3. B, gibberellic acid is bringing about bolting. So B is 3, D is 2. So you have to see which of them are there. B is 3 and D is 2. So both these options are having this. So A is 4, B is 3. C, ethylene, ripening of fruit. So this is correct. C is 5, D is 2, E is 1. Cytokinins in herring sperm of DNA. DNA, cytokinin, remember about it. So nucleotides, so you can remember. So first one is the correct option. Indole acetic acid, so is weed-free lawns, so you can obtain from them. So abscisic acid, so it is going to be the stomatal closure. Ethylene, so is the ripening of fruits. So then gibberellic acid, so they are bringing about bolting. And cytokinins, herring sperm of DNA. So first answer, 149th, first is the correct answer. 150th. The early embryos of various vertebrates exhibit the fundamental similarity. This is stated by, Von Baer has stated this. So again, out of syllabus part of it. The early embryos of various vertebrates, they exhibit fundamental similarity. So that is unity and diversity of embryos that you know about. So Von Baer has stated that. So 150 is first one is a correct answer. So 151st, match the column one with column two. So zoospore, conidia, gemmule, and buds. So buds, I think the hydra. So D is three. So D is three in two options. Okay. Then there is gemmule in sponges. So D is three. C is two. So C2, D3. So there are two options. B, conidia in penicillium. So conidia in penicillium. So fourth option is correct. Zoospore is in chlamydomonas. Conidia is in penicillium. Gemmule is in sponges. And buds is in hydra. So fourth option is correct for 151st. So T.R. Malthus. So some books you can easily identify about that. So natural selection, Charles Darwin, you can remember natural selection. Thomas Malthus on the principles of population. So 3-4. So it should begin with 3-4. Third option has that. Okay. So 152nd, the answer is 3-4-5-2. So T.R. Malthus on the principles of population, Charles Darwin, natural selection, Weismann, decaudalization experiments, that is August Weismann. You know that he cut for 20 generations the tail of rats, decaudalization experiment. So Weismann is fifth one. Then Lamarck, so philosophic zoology, he has authored the book Philosophic Zoologic. Okay. Lamarckism also he has spoken about. Alfred Russel Wallace on the tendency of varieties to depart from original types. So third option is correct for the 152nd. Third option is correct. So 153rd, what is the chromosome number in the meiocytes of human beings, fruit fly, ophioglossum, and zea maize? Respectively, meiocytes means the mother cells, the meiotic mother cells. So you have this options. Human beings is 46, fruit fly is 8, ophioglossum has very high 1260, zea maize is 20. So third option, so 153rd, so third option is correct. So 46, 8 in fruit fly, 1260 in ophioglossum, then 20 in case of zea maize. Read the following and arrange the above based on probable evolutionary sequence. So in which sequence they have evolved? So Ramapithecus, then Australopithecus, EF, Homo habilis, Homo erectus, Homo neanderthalensis, and Homo sapiens. So this is the correct sequence, fourth one. EFDACB, Ramapithecus, Australopithecus, Homo habilis, Homo erectus, then Homo neanderthalensis, Homo sapiens. EFDACB, 154th, fourth option is correct. Find out correct order of vegetative propagules of plants like potato, ginger, agave, bryophyllum, and water hyacinth. What are the vegetative propagules? Potato is tuber. Ginger is rhizome, agave is bulbil, bryophyll is leaf bud, water hyacinth, they have offset. So tuber, so the correct sequence of vegetative propagules from potato, okay. Eyes of potato, rhizome, bulbil or bulbil, leaf buds, and offset. So third one is the correct option for 155th. So match the following. So the correct match is, which is the correct match you have to find out among this. See, typhoid fever, they have given four options. So A is two they have given. Yes, it is correct. A is two, typhoid fever. Then D, they have given salmonella, typhoid fever, salmonella, intestinal perforation, typhoid fever. That might not be the correct combination. A to C, dry and scaly lesions. So the 156th, this option is correct. Typhoid fever, salmonella, dry and scaly lesions. So A to C. So you have to see the answer and then correct it. B, pneumonia. So it can be by streptococcus. So B3, A, fluid filled alveoli. Common cold, rhinovirus. C4, B, nasal congestion. D, ringworm, microsporum. D1, D, intestinal perforations. So ringworm, D1, D. So the fourth option is right for this question. So 156th, fourth option is right. So 157th, read the following statements. Okay, so you have to find out the correct statements. The pollen grains are light and non-sticky. Stamens are well exposed from the flowers. Very often feathery stigmas are present. Single ovule in each ovary is present. Flowers are packed into inflorescence. Which of the following statements are correct in with respect to anemophilous plants? So first statement, so anemophilous is wind pollinated flowers. First one, second one, third one, fourth one, fifth one. So all of these are correct. So 1 to 5. So D is correct here. So which of the following provides the sites for interaction of lymphocytes with the antigen? So which of the following provides the sites for interaction of lymphocytes with the antigen? So the 158th. So B, D, E, and F. So B is nothing but spleen. So spleen is going to provide, so the sites for interaction of lymphocytes with the antigen. So spleen, lymph nodes, E is appendix, and F is Peyer's patches of small intestine. So they are going to provide the site for interaction of lymphocytes with the antigen. So you should remember it as B, D, E, and F. B is spleen, D is lymph nodes, E is appendix, and F is Peyer's patches. So these are the sites for interaction of lymphocytes with the antigen. So B, D, E, and F, that is the right answer. So 159th, arrange A, B, C, D, and E in the sequence of dicot embryo development from zygote stage. So it would be D. So B, D, A, E, C. B, D, A, C, E, C. So fourth one is correct. So 159th, fourth one is correct. So the zygote proembryo, then you have this globular embryo, heart-shaped embryo, finally mature embryo. So that is BDAEC. The exaggerated human response of the immune system to certain antigens is called hypersensitivity. So 160, the answer is hypersensitivity. The exaggerated human immune response of the immune system to certain antigens, we call it as hypersensitivity. So 160th, second one is the correct answer. So an exoploid female plant gets pollinated by an octoploid male plant as a result of double fertilization. Okay, what will be the ploidy of embryo and endosperm respectively? So haploid of this is 4N, 4 plus 3 is 6N. So the zygote would be 7N, 4 plus 3 is 7N. Then there is a fusion of 3 nuclei. So they would all be 4 plus 4, 8N, plus So that is going to be diploidy of embryo and endosperm respectively. So 7N and 11N should be here. It is wrong here. 4 plus 4, 8N plus 3N, it should be 11N. Okay, there's a mistake there. So it is not 10N. Third one, 7N, 11N, it should be. So make that correction in your paper. Okay, so it would be the fusion of male and female egg cells. So hexaploid female plant. So it would be hexaploid female plant gets pollinated. So half of hexaploid is 3N plus 4N, 7N. So 3N plus 4N plus 4N for triple fusion. So there would be two polar nuclei in the egg cell, isn't it? And they are going to be 4N plus 4N. Okay. No. They are correct. So since female plant they have given, it would be 3N plus 3N, 6N plus 4N. 7N and 10N is correct. So I just overlooked this female plant. Hexaploid is female plant. So the embryo sac will be within this female plant. So it's a very clever question. Okay, if you overlook this female part of it, so you'll get a wrong answer. So 7N plus 10N is correct. So third option is correct. GEAC means Genetic Engineering Approval Committee. So that is second one is the correct option, 162nd. So how many different types of gametes would be formed in an individual who is heterozygous for 4 different loci? How many different types of gametes would be formed in an individual who is heterozygous for 4 different loci? So 163rd, so 4 different loci is there, heterozygous they are there. The answer is 16. So 16 types of gametes would be formed in an individual who is heterozygous for 4 different loci. So 4 different loci are 4 different positions. So they are 4 different genes. For dihybrid itself, we got that. 16 types of gametes would be formed in an individual who is heterozygous for 4 different loci. Okay, so you just have to, instead of writing dihybrid, tetrahybrid cross, you should make. So you are going to get 16 types of gametes. So match the following. So list 1, list 2. Allen's rule, what is it applied for? So Bergman's rule, coral rule, animals, Wandt Hof's rule. So these are the options in the 164th question. See, Allen's rule is temperature effect on length of extremities. Okay, from the body to the tail, from the head to tail, temperature effect on length of extremities. Allen's rule. Bergman's rule, body volume temperature. Body volume temperature. Coral animals, stenothermal. Wandt Hof's rule, temperature metabolic rate. So you should mark this up. So Bergman's rule, volume, body volume temperature. Allen's rule, temperature effect on length of extremities. Coral animals are stenothermal. Wandt Hof's rule is temperature metabolic rate. So first one is correct answer. So there are some concepts outside of the syllabus here, so you should know about it. Okay, so 164, the first option is right. Allen's rule is temperature effect on length of extremities. Bergman's rule, body volume temperature. Coral animals, stenothermal. Wandt Hof's rule, temperature metabolic rate. So study the following list. Again, there's a match the following question. So T.H. Morgan. So what did he do? Linkage he studied about. G.J. Mendel. Okay, Mendel, loss of heredity. So there is linkage. So 2-4. Bateson. So coined the term genetics. 2-4-1. D, Reginald Punnett checkerboard, D3. See, second is the correct answer for 165th. The correct answer is second one. So T.H. Morgan, linkage. G.J. Mendel, loss of heredity. Bateson coined the term genetics. Punnett square, we call it as checkerboard. So Reginald Punnett, checkerboard. So second one is the correct option. So 165th second option is the correct. Obligatory relationship between two organisms in which both are benefited is called proto-cooperation, amensalism, commensalism, mutualism. So it is obligatory, mandatory relationship. So that is going to be, so the 166, the answer is mutualism. D is the answer. So a heterozygotic tall plant, that is hybrid tall, is crossed with homozygous dwarf plant. So it is hybrid with, this is like test cross. So 1:1:1:1. Then what will be the percentage of dwarf plants in the next generation? So when it is crossed, what will be the percentage of dwarf plants in the next generation? 50%, okay? So 50% dwarf plants, 50% tall plants. So 167th, second one is the answer. It is test cross. Okay, just remember that 1:1. So 50% is the answer. Identify the logistic growth equation. Dn by dt, Rn by k minus n by n. So the first one is the correct statement. So let us check the logistic growth equation, whether it is right or not. So 168, the correct answer is C. Dn by dt, Rn by k minus n by k, not n, k minus n by k. So third is the correct equation. Which of the following correctly represents DNA replication? Okay, so towards the ring, it is continuous. Away from the ring, it is discontinuous. So that replication, you know, continuous strand, leading strand, lagging strand. So away from the replication fork, towards the floor of replication fork, it is continuous. Away from the replication fork, it is discontinuous. So 169th, so the first one correctly represents the replication fork. So 169th, A, or the first one is the correct part of it. All automobiles in India have met Euro 4 norms by April 1, 2010, April 1, 2012, May 5th, 2014, May 5th, 2000. So which is that right answer for this Euro 4 norms automobiles in India? So BS4. Okay, now we have this presently it is, I think BS6 is there. So BS4, when did it became mandatory? So the answer for the 170th is A, April 1, 2010. Okay, now in the month of April 10th, 2020, so the BS6 norms came by. So remember that, that might also be asked. So 170th, first one is the correct answer. In sea urchin DNA, which is double-stranded, 17% of the bases were shown to be cytosine. So cytosine, adenine always base pairs with thymine, cytosine base pairs with guanine. So guanine will also have 17%. 17 plus 17, it is 34%. So 34% you have remaining will be 66%. So adenine will be 33 and thymine will be 33. So the percentages of other bases are expected are, so guanine 17%, adenine 13%. Fourth option is correct. So this is a very nice question. So if you have understood that base equivalence rule, okay, Chargaff's base equivalence rule, they are using it. So adenine, the amount of adenine is equal to the amount of guanine, and the amount of cytosine is equal to amount of guanine. The amount of adenine is always equal to amount of thymine. So using that, we have derived this. Okay. So fourth one is the correct answer. Ozone layer of upper atmosphere is being destroyed by chlorofluorocarbons. So 172nd, third one is the answer. 173rd, So which of the following Cri-gene codes for the protein which can control the corn borer effectively? Okay, which of the genes can control them effectively? So 173rd, the answer is the third one, Cry1AB. So Cry1AB can effectively control the corn borer. So it Cri-gene code, Cry1AB codes for the protein which can control the corn borer. So third one is the answer. So 174th, first biosphere reserve was established in 1986 at Nilgiri. Okay, Nilgiri, they established the first biosphere reserve. So 174th, first one is the answer. So 175th, which of the following are varieties of wheat? Kalyan Sona and Sonalika are the varieties of wheat. 175th, second one is the correct answer. Okay. 176th, which option correctly describes the curves of equations of curves A and B in the given graph of species area relationship, species richness and area relationship? So which option correctly describes the sequence of it? Okay. So the 176, the answer is first option is correct. S equals CAZ, logarithm of S equals log C plus Z into log A. So first option is a correct description of this graph of species area relationship. A is S equals CAZ, B is log S equals log C plus Z log A. So it is linear, okay. The biological oxygen demand test measures the rate of oxygen uptake by microbes in a sample of water to oxidize organic matter production, air quality, organic matter used by herbivore fishes. So what does the biological oxygen demand test measures? Okay, so the 177th, the answer is first one. It is used to measure oxygen uptake by microbes in a sample of water to oxidize organic matter. That itself indicates BOD test measures the rate of oxygen uptake by microbes in a sample of water to oxidize organic matter. Okay. Also, a glomerular kidney exists in. So which of them, they do not have glomerulas? So a glomerular kidney exists in marine bony fishes. Okay, the figure given below is the diagrammatic representation of the E. coli vector PBR322. Which of the given options correctly identify its certain components? Okay, so ORI, original restriction enzyme, that is wrong. ROP, okay, reduced osmotic pressure, that is also wrong. 3, hint 3. Ampicillin resistant, tetracycline resistance, antibiotic resistance gene. So marker genes also, we can call them as AMPR and tetracycline resistance genes. They are correctly mentioned. So fourth one is the correct option for 179th. So 180th, association between cattle egret and grazing cattle is assumed, plus sign for beneficial organism and minus sign for detrimental. See, cattle egret, it is plus. And grazing egret, it is zero. So plus and zero is the answer. So second one is the correct one. Okay. So plus and zero. So for 180th, second question is, second choice is right. Okay, with this, we have completed today's session. Any doubts you have?